Today we're talking with Tim Erickson. We're here at the Santa Fe National Conference on Wilderness and Travel Medicine. Tim is a professor of emergency medicine and toxicology at the University of Illinois and a specialist on snake bites. So we have a few questions for Timothy. First of all, thanks for coming out to MedWild.
It's great to be here. Beautiful weather and can't beat the setting.
Is this a common scenario where people are bitten, just hikers out in the wilderness and suddenly a snake jumps out of a tree and bites them?
It's not as common as people would like to think, but certainly in the setting here in the Southwest, New Mexico, Arizona, Utah, you are going to get snake bites, pit vipers predominantly, rattlesnakes, Mohaves, Western Diamondbacks. So if you're rummaging around, you're hiking, you're going into brush off trail, yeah, you're susceptible to snakes. Now they're not going to stalk you, they're not going to come flying out of trees, they're not like anacondas that are going to devour you, but they are going to strike if disturbed. So if you step on them, reach over a log, they may strike. They'd rather leave you alone. They're poikiotherms, cold-blooded. They'd rather just sit still, absorb the heat, and not waste their venom on humans. They'd much rather have rodents, rabbits, etc. The people we are treating really are those that are messing with snakes. They're taking chances. They have pet rattlesnakes. They're a little intoxicated, and usually they're males, so they got testicles. And yes, sometimes testicles are bitten. But these are the type of patients we get, the ones that are messing, pushing the limit, not the ones that are hiking out on a trail. If you're just respecting it, staying on trail, certainly if you're going to go off into the bush, create, blaze your own trail, then you're asking for it because you may inadvertently step on one and then it's going to defend itself.
When you're hiking along, what are you thinking about in terms of prevention?
Well, first, I'm on another planet, you know, I'm never thinking much, but prevention-wise, stay on the trail, make a little noise, give the snakes a chance to crawl away, and they will. If you see one directly on the trail, respect it, go around it, usually you're going to be fine. So know that they're there, respect their habitat, they don't want to encounter you, they don't want to mess with you, and usually you'll just be fine. Now there's certain snakes internationally that are a little more pugnacious and will go after you, the mambas, the cobras.
In your experience, how often do you see snake bites that result in no envenomation at all?
It's actually quite often. If it's a non-venomous snake, like a garter snake,
I'm assuming a venomous snake.
Okay, if it's a venomous snake, about a third, even 40%, will be a dry bite. Again, snakes don't want to waste venom on humans. They can't devour a human. They'll strike, realize it's not a small rat, rodent, and will draw back. So you'll get envenomated, you'll see puncture wounds, but there won't be the poison injected into the victim. So you'll get a dry bite, you'll feel pain, but you won't see the manifestations of the bite, swelling of the arm, leg, blistering. You may be hysterical because you think you're going to die, but the vast majority won't die, and quite a large amount, again a third, it's a dry bite.
In a lot of first aid books, and even wilderness medicine books, there's a suggestion that if somebody's bitten by a presumed venomous snake, that they should somehow bring that snake with them to the emergency room so that it can be identified. How do you feel about that?
Not necessary. If you're in a habitat, a natural setting, you are going to know what type snakes are indigenous to the area. And they're going to be treated the same. So to send the victim back into the bush, or you yourself trying to save the day to wrestle the big anaconda or the venomous Mohave rattler, makes no sense. You're going to get harmed, you're going to harm the staff trying to care for the patient. Let it be, let it retreat, you're going to treat it the same. Same antivenom covers all the snakes that are indigenous to the area. The only exception is if, again, someone's messing with the snakes and it's an exotic international snake, that's a different story. You may want to identify it. Otherwise, off the trail, in the wilderness, leave it be. We're going to treat it the same.
Sometimes people presume that when they're hiking, and if they're careful and observant, that they'll hear a rattlesnake rattle before it bites. Would you agree with that?
No. Classically, it's not going to rattle until you're almost on top of it. It will retreat. It's not going to be rattling left and right, warning you. It's usually once they're intimidated, they're defending themselves, you're in their territory. So just because you don't hear a rattle doesn't mean there are not snakes around. So you have to be cautious. Don't use that as a barometer whether there's snakes, whether it's safe to go off trail.
We've been talking a lot about local snakes.
Correct, yeah.
What about people that are doing adventure travel, they're traveling traveling internationally? Is there anything that they should keep in mind?
Yeah, we're used to seeing pit vipers, rattlesnakes, blood, hematotoxic snakes. When they go internationally, they're going to see more nerve neurotoxic snakes like cobras and crates, and they may look different. So you may say, hey, I know what a rattlesnake looks like. I know the shape of its head, diamondback, those elliptical eyes. Snakes internationally may be round-eyed, they may be small, they may have no rattles. They could be more venomous, more dangerous than our snakes that are indigenous to the U.S. The best thing to do, unless you know what you're doing, stay away from them. Trust your local guides. Even internationally, please stay on the trail. They're there for a reason. Don't mess with Mother Nature. Don't mess with the snakes. Leave them be, and we can all get along, and it'll be a beautiful planet, Howard.
Oh. So did snakes on a plane suck?
Actually, I liked it. It got bad reviews. It got panned by the critics. But I love Samuel L. Jackson. And I think the original title for the movie was supposed to be like Vipers in the Stratosphere. But Samuel Jackson said, no, it's about snakes on a plane, and we're going to call it Snakes on a Plane. So yeah, it did suck, but I've seen it 7 times because I like snakes.